Epigastric burning or pain. Epigastric burning and pain are one of the common complaints in general practice, and usually they are related to acid peptic disorders. There are four common presentations. First is burning or sharp pain in the epigastric region, more to the right side. This pain is always related to meals. In duodenal ulcers, it is relieved by food only to reappear after 2 to 3 hours. And in gastric ulcer and gastritis, it increases immediately after food. Early morning pain at 3 a.m. or 5 a.m. in the morning is typical of duodenal ulcer. The second complaint is regurgitation of sour fluid in the throat and retrosternal burning pain. Most of the patients of hyperacidity and ulcer have sour regurgitations after meals. And when reflux esophagitis develops, it is associated with retrosternal burning pain, which is more after meals. If this symptom is very severe, then a hiatus hernia should be suspected. Thirdly, many patients complain of epigastric fullness and bloating sensation after meals. And though there are other causes for this symptom, more commonly it is a manifestation of very mild peptic pain. But if it is not relieved by antacids and enzymes, then gallstones and pyloric obstruction should be ruled out by ultrasonography and gastroscopy. Lastly, the epigastric pain may sometimes radiate to the back. If it is radiating to the back, ask in details whether the pain is related to the meals. If it is related to the meals, usually relieved by meals, then it is more likely to be due to duodenal ulcer when the ulcer is on the posterior wall of duodenum. But if the pain is continuous, not related to food, one must think of chronic pancreatitis, which will be diagnosed by ultrasonography or CT scan. When these symptoms are of very short duration, a general practitioner will give medical treatment and observe. The symptomatic treatment will comprise of one acid-inhibiting drug like omeprazole 20 mg OD or ranitidine 150 mg BD or rabeprazole 20 mg OD or famotidine 40 mg OD. That's your choice. Secondly, one antacid like Gelucil MPS or Digin is a must, as it gives instant soothing effect on the mucosa and immediate pain relief. If the patient is anxious or excited, do give a tablet of Restil 0.25 mg at night for 2 days. Last and very important part of the treatment is to remove the factor that is causing hyperacidity. Whenever a patient tells about hyperacidity symptoms or pain, always, reflexly and unmistakably, always ask whether he is taking any medications. Has he taken any anti-inflammatory drugs or steroids for joint pains or backache or for asthma? Is it drug-induced gastritis? If yes, the most important thing would be to stop the irritant drug immediately. Also, ask the patient not to eat chilies and sour foods till the pain subsides. Ask him not to smoke or not to take alcohol if he has been taking it. If the patient is anxious or tensed up, give a tablet of alprazolam. So, look for an irritation factor for the hyperacidity and remove it. This was our basic symptomatic treatment. If the symptoms do not subside within a few days of treatment, or if they keep recurring after stopping the treatment, or if they are very severe, that is severe pain or severe regurgitation and vomiting, then the patient needs to be investigated by asking for a gastroscopy, that is upper GI endoscopy, and ultrasonography. If gastritis or duodenitis or gastric or duodenal ulcer are detected, a biopsy or test for H. pylori must be done at the same time. Now we will discuss in brief the treatment of the various common disorders. The first is chronic duodenal ulcer. For chronic duodenal ulcer, first give a complete 7-day course of H. pylori eradication combi pack. It contains 3 drugs. First is omeprazole or lansoprazole. Second is one antibiotic, clarithromycin or amoxicillin. And third is antiamoebic, tinidazole or ornidazole. After the 7-day course, continue omeprazole or lansoprazole for at least 3 months. Secondly, give an antacid like Algel or Digin 2 teaspoonful TDS till complete symptomatic relief is obtained, that is for at least 10 to 15 days. In the acute phase, you should also give a tranquilizer like alprazolam 0.25 mg HS, not for sleep but for removing anxiety, an important hidden factor for the occurrence of the ulcer. Lastly, give a high dose of B-complex also. Apart from the drug treatment, advise a bland diet, no chilies, no sour foods, more of cold milk, then no smoking, no alcohol, no starvations, no late nights, regular meals and regular sleep. And most important, no gastric irritant drugs like aspirin, NSAIDs or steroids. The treatment for gastric ulcer and gastritis is also basically the same, but in a gastric ulcer, it is very important to repeat gastroscopy after 8 weeks to confirm whether the ulcer is healed or not, because there are significant chances of a gastric ulcer being malignant. Next, we come to GERD, that is gastroesophageal reflux disease, which includes reflux esophagitis and hiatus hernia. The aim of treatment in these disorders is to suppress acid secretion and prevent regurgitation. So prescribe a proton pump inhibitor like omeprazole 20 mg OD and an antacid. If retrosternal burning is severe, give an antacid with oxythazine like Mucangel or Solacid O, which numbs the mucosa and gives better symptomatic relief. To regularize the esophageal mobility, give etopride like tabganatone 50 mg TDS. Lastly, to prevent regurgitation, instruct the patient to sit upright, not to lie down, for at least half an hour after meals, and the head end of the cot should be raised by 6 inches so that you sleep in slight head high position. If this is not possible, take pillows under the shoulders and head to get a head high position. Now that we have discussed about acid peptic disorders, we must always remember that epigastric pain is not always due to hyperacidity and ulcer. Few other conditions should also be kept in mind when the symptoms are different or when the response to antacid treatment is not satisfactory. If the pain is colicky and if epigastrium is tender, think of amoebic colitis. Ask about history of mucus and blood in the stools, increased frequency of motions, and whether there is urgency of motions after food. Get the stools checked and treat with tinidazole 500 mg BD for 5 days. If the pain is more in right hypochondrium, if there is fullness of upper abdomen after meals, and if there is tenderness under the right costal margin, then chronic cholecystitis should be considered. Ask for ultrasonography and the diagnosis will be clear. If the epigastric pain radiates to the back, again chronic pancreatitis should be ruled out by ultrasonography or CT scan. A tender left lobe of liver in congestive cardiac failure or in hepatitis may also give epigastric pain. But careful and gentle palpation in the epigastrium will always detect the liver and its soft lower edge. Lastly, one must also be aware that cardiac pain due to angina or myocardial infarct may sometimes radiate to the epigastric region. If the pain appears on exertion, angina must be suspected irrespective of its location. A ECG should be taken. And if there is associated sweating or low BP, then cardiac pain due to myocardial infarct must be thought of.